Buenos dias, everybody. So today I have a Candles by Victoria review for you. And this is actually going to be Christmas scents. I saw somebody did a review of fall scents and I thought like favorite fall scents. I thought that was a good idea. So I was going to do that too, but I have a crazy ton of fall scents. So I thought I would do Christmas scents because I have less of those. And so the link down is down below for the fall scents. So first things like started, I apologize for the mess behind me and the way I look. I just woke up and I felt like doing this video because I wanted to do it yesterday, but I've been sick for the past couple of days. so I was just like, screw it. I want to do it. It's the weekend. I'm not going to have time during the week. So I might as well just do it while I feel like doing it and not like wait to clean up or like get myself all pretty or whatever, because otherwise it just is not going to happen. Second of all, I know you guys may ask, but look at my arm. I don't know if I sprained my wrist or if I have like really bad carpal tunnel, which is kind of what I think it is, but like, oh, there was a long time where I would pop my wrist, and one time I popped my wrist a little too far or whatever, and it pulled something in here, and it's been fine. Like, I haven't had any problems, but over the last week, it's been, like, acting up really bad. Like, I can't grab anything. If I bend it, it hurts. So, super fun. Probably ought to go see a doctor about it, but I'm cheap, and I want to spend my money on candles. Anyway. so that's that, like, drama, I guess, the prefacing for all the crap that you are about to see up in this video. All of these scents I have reviewed before, but since they are Christmassy and people might be starting to think about what kind of Christmas candles they want to order, you know, for like November, December, I thought I would just do a review on those. So I will get started. The first one is Let It Snow. This is a minty scent, and it is like minty, like eucalyptus, peppermint, and it has cinnamon in it, and it is so good. I love this scent, and in my most recent order, which I'll do a review once it gets here, I ordered a 9-ounce, and I thought I was ordering a 9-ounce in this, and I accidentally ordered a 9-ounce in Winter Snowflake, which is also still nice, but it's not the not what I wanted, which was Let It Snow, so I think I'm going to have to place an order to get this. Oh, dang, twist my arm. but yeah, so it's like I said, eucalyptus, cinnamon, and it's like the like red hot cinnamon and peppermint. And it's really nice, and I had it on the warmer yesterday, and it's really strong, and it made my house smell very minty and fresh, which was really nice because I wasn't feeling very well. But it's super good, so if you're looking for a different kind of Christmassy scent, my favorite that I have is Sweet Snow, which actually I should have brought over here. It's in my Snowflake candle. Sweet Snow is a mint and vanilla, like a peppermint vanilla, and it smells exactly like a candy cane. There's not really a whole lot else to describe other than it smells like a candy cane. So if you don't want like a candy cane scent, but you want like a nice mint scent, I do recommend Let It Snow. The next one is Winter Snowflake. Winter Snowflake is also a peppermint, but it's mixed with pine. So it's like a peppermint. It's like a sweet peppermint. Maybe a hint of vanilla in there. Not as much as Sweet Snow, where it's like a candy cane, kind of. It's just like a hint of vanilla and peppermint and pine. So if you like sugared spruce, I think you would like Winter Snowflake if you're interested in getting a mint scent. To me, it just kind of reminds me of like a frosted, pine tree or Christmas tree. Like when sometimes they like spray that fake frost on it. I don't know if you guys have ever seen that. But anyway, that's like I would think that this would smell like if it was like real. Like it's just minty. It's a minty Christmas tree. It's a very nice scent. The next one I have is Cinnamon Stick, and I thought that this seemed like a Christmas scent to me because, I feel like, you know, around Christmas time, there's just all kinds of, like, cinnamon is in a lot of stuff. And I've actually had this scent shot since my very first order. So, yeah, I've had it a long time, and I've only melted half of it. And this is, like, a straight-up red-hot cinnamon. There's not really anything else to say, but it's, like, red-hot. It has a little bit of a twang that's not quite as cinnamony. I mean, like, it definitely is like a red hot cinnamon, but there's just something in there that kind of tones it down so it's not quite as intense. So if you like that scent and you like it super intense, that it's not quite as strong as you might be thinking. But if you like it but you don't like it because it's so super strong like this, or some that are like that, then this will be a better option for you. This is Peppermint Bark, which is a very, very popular scent. It is mint and chocolate, like white chocolate. People just like rave about this scent. They go on and on and on about it. And I'm not a fan of cold throw. I obviously have not melted it yet. I just can't bring myself to I'm just not such a fan. And I love like mint and chocolate scents. I think that, and you'll see, yeah, there's another one in here. And it's just like, it's definitely a white chocolate, or like, maybe it's a dark chocolate. No, it might be dark chocolate. It's not milk chocolate, let's put it that way. And the more I smell it, the more I'm kind of like getting used to it, but it's a lot heavier on the chocolate than the mint, and I prefer mine to be heavier on the mint. It is creamy, which is very nice. I probably will end up melting this sometime soon so I can see what it's like warm, but cold I'm not as crazy about it. But I can tell you that it is one of the most popular chocolate and mint scents. So many people rave about it. They absolutely love it. And I think that most have said that they like it better warm. So I would definitely give that a shot. So if you're looking for like that kind of minty, chocolatey scent, that might be it for you. And the next one I have is Eggnog. And I really like this one. I got it in a swap and I haven't melted any of it yet, which is another thing. I need to start getting through my scent shots and warming these. And to me, it doesn't necessarily smell like eggnog, but it smells like sweet cream with like buttery and maybe a hint of like some spices, like maybe nutmeg or cinnamon. I really like this. I just need to warm it up already. It's really good. Like I said, I don't think it smells like how I would say eggnog smells, but it is sweet cream and butteriness, and it's really good. I really, really like it. The next one is Christmas Apple Cider Snap. And I was kind of on the fence about this when I first got it. I was like, oh, I don't really like it. I love this shiznit now. It is so good. Oh, it is like, it's definitely apple cider, and then it has like all of those, you know, like when you walk into like a Michael's or Joann's, it has like those spices mixed in with the apple cider. Oh, it is amazing. I think I'm going to get this in a candle, and I'm not lying, I wasn't such a big fan of it, but it's freaking good. So Christmas apple cider snap, if you are looking for like that perfect apple-y and spicy kind of scent for Christmas, I would say this one because it's freaking amazing. The next one I have is Christmas Eve, and I was really on the fence about this. Oh, not on the fence. I was really excited to order this one. There's another one that I got confused on. Anyway, but Christmas Eve, it was, so when you go to order, if you look at the master fragrance list, there's one that says simmering spices. I don't know if it's been fixed, but simmering spices is actually part of the description for Christmas Eve. So it's actually Christmas Eve that you want to order. Not that you can't order simmering spices anyway. Anyway, but it's spices and like a creaminess, and like a vanilla or something. It does smell, it smells like those kind of fragrances you get when you walk into Joann's, I think. And a hint of creaminess behind it. It's pretty good, but it's almost a little generic. Just because, and I think, honestly, I do think it's because I haven't warmed it. Because mostly I'm smelling those holiday smells, like the holiday spices is mostly what I get, which hence simmering spices is part of the description. I mean, it smells good. Don't get me wrong. But I'm not picking out really a whole lot of other notes in it. But if you're looking for like those kind of like Joann type spices, with like creaminess behind it versus like an apple scent, then I would say Christmas Eve is a good one. It's very nice. Chocolate mint. This is my favorite of the mint and chocolate scents. I also had chocolate peppermint slash, but I have swapped that one. So this one is definitely my favorite. It smells exactly like an Andes mint. And there are people who say that they think peppermint bark smells like an Andes mint, and it doesn't. This smells like an Andes mint. It is the perfect blend of peppermint and chocolate. And it is exactly what it smells like. I cannot wait to get this thing going. I'm definitely ordering it in a candle. There's really not a whole lot else I can really describe it as. Like, there's a sweet peppermint, almost like the candy cane kind of peppermint, and chocolate. It is a perfect mint. It smells exactly like, open up an Andes mint, smell it, and put it in your mouth, and that's what you get out of chocolate mint. The next one is sugared spruce. And I put this in the Christmas scent because it smells like a tree, because it smells like a Christmas tree. It's like a very pine tree. But I think a lot of people have said that they would burn this year round, which is, I think, true for a lot of people. It's a little bit strong for me, and I'm not as big of a green fan, or like a tree fan, I guess, like a woodsy kind of fan. But this, it's very nice. It smells like, I think it's supposed to be a mix of pink sugar and like Christmas tree, like a pine tree, and that's exactly what it smells like. It's sweet, and when I close my eyes, like when I'm smelling it, what I picture is the tips of a pine tree or like a Christmas tree covered in pink sugar crystals. That's what I see in my head, because that's exactly what it would smell like. It's really, really nice scent, and if you like woodsy scents or pine scents or even just like a different sweet kind of scent, this would be a good one for you. I only have three more, Raised Hot Cocoa and Marshmallows. I got this to mix with Peppermint Patty, and I haven't done it yet. And when I first got it, all I smelled was like generic fake chocolate. I didn't smell anything, but it's had a little bit. I've had it for a while now. And now it smells like rich chocolate. I don't know that it smells exactly hot chocolate. Wow. It's definitely one of those days, guys. I don't know that it smells exactly like regular, just like straight hot chocolate, which it's not supposed to. It's supposed to have like marshmallows and stuff in it, but it is richer. It is a very rich, deeper chocolate, but it's definitely a milk chocolate. It's really good. I'm really, really liking it. Like I said, I didn't like it when I first bought it. I thought that it smelled fake, but now that it's sat around for a while, it smells a lot better. So if you're looking for that perfect kind of homey, chocolatey, like hot chocolate kind of scent, that would be it for you. This is the one that I was thinking, I was on the fence about, Old Fashioned Christmas. I think it's just like a bunch of spices and some citrus. And that's pretty much what I smell. I'm not the biggest fan of this because I think that I prefer Christmas apple cider snap and Christmas Eve to this one. It's again those, you walk into Michael's, you walk into Joanne's scent, and then that the scent that brings up the rear, like the bottom note, is orange. But it's not like, it's like orange peel. So if that sounds appealing to you, I think that this would be it. It kind of reminds me of like those kind of punches that you can get around Christmas time that people make. I feel like I only see them in movies. and it's like the big glass punch bowl, and it's got like this red punch in it, and then it has like all those slices of oranges. Like, that's what this kind of reminds me of. So it's good, and if you really like citrus scents and you like the spiciness, this would be a different and interesting one to try. The last one is one I got in a swap. It is blueberry candy cane, and I really like this one. It is blueberry. It's like a sweet candy cane. Like if you were to go get one of those, like those packs that have those candy cane packs that have all the different flavors in it, like the strawberry and the cherry and the blueberry and all of those. I think those are pretty much the only ones you get, like an apple maybe. That's what this smells like. I get her blueberry scent, but it's kind of overpowered a little bit by the peppermint, but it's not like you're smelling it and it's like, bam, peppermint. It's just like you're smelling it and it's like, oh, there's blueberry. Oh, there's peppermint. Like it's not as rich as like her blueberry cobbler and blueberry cheesecake of a blueberry. And I think it's because it's way toned down by the peppermint. But the peppermint is not overpowering like a peppermint patty because it's toned down so much by the blueberry, because those are both really strong scents. So together, that's very toned down and mild scent. So it's really good. And if you're looking for something that's a little bit different in the mint or candy cane type scent, that would be the one for you. So that's all that I have. I hope you guys enjoyed this and you found it somewhat helpful. If you are going to be ordering anytime soon before October 25th, I'd appreciate it if you use my my hostess code. So I'm doing an online candle party. The code is 2460. You probably have seen it up here. Make sure you also use the 10% discount that Victoria is offering. It's CB Victoria. You can put it in the discount box. And then after you put it in there, you make sure you hit recalculate. And then for the code, my online candle party code, you would put it in the comments section, just 2460. If you have any questions about any of these scents or anything about Candles by Victoria, I'm happy to answer them for you. I've had a lot of wonderful new subscribers and people sending me messages, and I'm just trying to get back to you guys, and hopefully I'm helping you out a little bit. If you... I forgot what I was going to say. I lost it. This is what happens when you do a video and you're like not fully awake and sick. So, yay! Anyway, I hope you guys are all having a great day. Oh, if you would like to see a fall one or like a bakery one of these or like a clean scent one or anything like that, maybe a fruity one, let me know, because I kind of have my candles divided out and I was thinking about doing reviews kind of like this, not reviews, but like just going over and like saying these are the ones that I have and these are the ones that I really like and recommend, or you know, what have you, like these are my favorite whatever scents. With Christmas, these are my only Christmas scents. So I did that, but I have a lot of fall ones, so I could just pick out my favorites. I don't know. What do you guys want? Like, would you want to see something like that? If so, if you leave me a comment below, I'd appreciate it. And I hope you guys all have a wonderful rest of your weekend, and I will see you soon with another video. Hope you're having a great day. Bye.